And our guest today is Suzanne Chess and Bob Evans. Desalination is their primary passion because coastal desalination is harming the world's ecosystem. So together they are developing a new patented desalination system that adds freshwater supply sustainably.
Water is going to be crucial, and I think we have a way to bring water in a way that's never been done before.
And this came out of, I guess, Bob's work, 6,000 hours he's been under the water, and he realized that the amount of pressure underwater is so significant that if you wanted to desalinate water, you wouldn't have to do it with pumps. All you would have to do is let the pressure of the deep water push the salt water through membranes, like reverse osmosis, and what would come out the other side is clean water. Is that basically the idea?
Exactly.
Think of it as a little submarine with a reverse osmosis system in it, and they're modular, and then you collect them together and have them extract the water through pipelines.
70% of the oxygen we breathe on our planet comes from plankton, and I think that's Suzanne and our biggest concern is the intake of plankton around our planet.
I don't know that people realize that there is no coastal desalinization method that doesn't destroy billions of protoplankton.
Yep.
It's not like you get the, there's a clean way to do it and a dirty way. There is no way to suck in that much with high-pressure pumps, destroying protoplankton and immature sea life.
And there's 16,000 desal plants around the world. So when there were just a few, no big deal.
Explain why your technology doesn't do that. Two ways. One, you use pressure, ambient pressure, so you're not sucking in protoplankton. So that's how you don't kill them. And number two, you're not taking the salt anywhere from where it wasn't already, which is at the bottom of the ocean. Is that basically what you're doing?
Well, no, it's a little more going on than that. The plankton and the, as the basis of the food chain, 90% of the life which feeds upon it live in the top 900 feet of water.
And your pipe is going to be at 1,700 feet, well below the 900 feet at which the protoplankton live and at which the fish are feeding on the protoplankton, I might add.
That's correct.
So it's clear we have to do something to get water. We have to do it in a way that doesn't create dead zones. We have to do it in a way that doesn't kill protoplankton. And we've got to add tens of thousands of more of these plants. I love that yours is modular. It can be done in a submersible way. And that you have got a solution, which I believe if government would get together with you folks as private enterprise and a few nonprofits who are interested in the oceans and the health of the oceans, I'll bet you we could pull it off. And I want to thank you again for all of your work. Incredibly, this incredible.
Well, you're our inspiration. You have inspired us. And thank you for giving Suzanne and I this opportunity.